And now we will learn how to record credits to customers' accounts. Let us imagine on February 24th, Holden gave Betty 2 video hours credit, specifically for invoice number 14. Here is Betty's open invoice report before Holden records the credit. We know that 2 video hours is equal to $600. Therefore, invoice number 14 will decrease by $600. And when Holden's finished recording the credit, invoice number 14 will go down to $3,400. Let's take a look at how to record this. Here's Betty's open invoice before we record the credit, and here's invoice number 14. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Credit Memo Refund. Notice QuickBooks remembers that this is the second credit memo we are making, and therefore automatically puts the number 2. If your screen does not have the number 2 in credit number, you should put the number 2 for this example. Click the calendar box and go back to February 24th. That's the day Holden is issuing the credit. We choose Betty as our customer. We click directly under the word item and choose the item we're giving credit for, which is video. Click directly under the word quantity and type the number 2. When we push tab, the credit memo totals $600. Now, look what happens at the moment we click save and close. First, we get a warning about the message. We know we're enumerating our credit memos correctly, so we just click keep number. Here's the most important pop-up, the available credit box. Are we going to give a refund, retain as credit, or apply to an invoice? Click on apply to an invoice. If you make that choice and you click OK, the apply credits to invoice window opens up. Notice QuickBooks assumes that you are applying the credit to the oldest one. We are not. Therefore, we have to uncheck the wrong one and recheck the correct one. In this case, we place the check mark on invoice number 14, which currently has a balance of $4,000 before applying the $600 credit. When we click done, we look back at the open invoice report and we notice the results are exactly as what we expected. Invoice number 14 has decreased to $3,400. What happens in the trial balance when you record a credit memo? Well, when you recorded your original invoice, accounts receivable and income both went up. Therefore, when you record a credit memo, accounts receivable and the same income account both go down. Therefore, this credit memo was recorded as a minus to account receivable, and in our example, a minus to video income. Let's open our trial balance and see what the numbers are as a result of the credit memo. When we double-click the video income account, or the number next to the video income, we see the video income account opens up. If you look all the way down here at the bottom, you see that the 2 credit memos that we made in this video and the recent video both caused video income to decrease. Let's close it out. When we double-click account receivable and we scroll to the very bottom, we can see that this credit memo decreases accounts receivable. It was $27,469. Then the credit memo we just recorded, which is credit memo number 2, decreased accounts receivable and made it $26,869.